Right, joining me now in studio is National List MP Claudette Hauiti. Tēnā koe, Claudette.
Kia ora, Scotty. It's great to be here. You know, my old stomping ground.
It's great to have you here.
Very different. And the kai played out in the green room's gotten smaller.
Is it a bit smaller?
Oh, yeah, it's a bit smaller.
It's a lot
but
more
I suppose
tastier,
it's relative
it's
to
tastier.
Your time on air.
Now, let's talk about this gay marriage bill because it was legitimised, for want of a better word, in Parliament this last week. You said in your maiden speech to Parliament that the strength in being takapui is in the knowing you are Māori. What did you mean by that?
Well, I think that knowing that you're Māori is the really strong, builds a really strong basis and foundation for anything that you do. And so I think it's also an indication that to our gay community that, you know, being Māori is really essential for us and that our worldview of being takatāpui is actually integrated, of bigger part of being Māori, and that we should not be identified as being gay only, but Māori has a particular type of construct for us.
Do you think that Māori people generally treat takapui better than others?
Oh yeah, we're fabulous. Yeah. Well, it depends. I mean, you know, we have our issues. Absolutely, we have our issues. But we also have our greatest supporters as well too, at whānau, hapū and iwi level. So it depends. It depends. I think that's a really big question.
We've got Grant Robertson at the moment, who could quite possibly get the Labour leadership and then could quite possibly be the first gay Prime Minister of New Zealand. Do you think we are ready to have a gay Prime Minister?
Well, I'm not sure about whether New Zealand is ready for a gay Prime Minister, but I think in terms of Labour, it should not be whether they are gay or not, it's whether they're really strong. And at this point in time, I do not see any match for our Prime Minister, John Key. They have to be ready to take him on, and there is no one in their ranks or on their reserves bench that can match our Prime Minister and our front bench as well too. We are really strong across all our portfolios. So whether they are gay or whether they are Māori or whether they are wahine or tāne, it is about the calibre of the individual.
How have your national colleagues treated you so far? You've been in Parliament for a little while now. How have they treated you? I mean, you're a Māori woman, you're gay, you're, you know, first time in Parliament. You carry all of these issues in with you, which are not generally National Party issues, National Party policies. You're not really the type of a National Party person. What sort of, you know, how have they treated you in Parliament so far?
Well, actually, I am. I am very reflective of the broader church of the National Party.
Are they a church now?
Well, you know, all organisations. Are, you know, have a congregation, and I'm reflective of the broader church that is the National Party, and I'm just representative of that in caucus as well too. And in terms of, you know, how my colleagues have welcomed me with open arms, you know, I would really like to be the golden child, but at the, you know, I don't think I am. I think Paul Foster Bell is that, but I'm working really hard on it. But there are expectations on me to ensure that what I said I would do for to advantage the position of the government, I will do that. And my relationship with Māori, I'm to, you know, help build that, because we have got some really fantastic work by some of our ministers, Minister Finlayson particularly, in treaty settlements and treaty negotiations.
I can see you're so motivated and so excited about this new position. I'm sure you've got a really great career in front of you in politics. We've run out of time, but Claudette, thank you very much. We appreciate you coming in this morning.
Wonderful.
Kia ora. Kia ora. Tēnā koe.